now I think there's something I can say now that I write my wrongs. I finally talked to God.
Antonio Miller, now are you still in school, Antonio?
No, sir.
Okay, you're going to Tri-C also, right? You're playing at 10 Tri-C. You know what you plan on taking?
Culinary arts.
Culinary arts. Now, a lot of you that's watching this are into the culinary arts. Not so much the cooking of it all, you know. Y'all might be into tasting goods and that thing. What turns you on to wanting to get into the culinary field?
When I was younger, my mom would never let me cook. So I went to Job Corps, and they finally let me cook because I took the culinary program there, and I was excited about it because it's something I've never done before. So I liked it a lot. For me to actually get my hands on different things, you know, working. I love eating different textures of food, learning different food from different cultures and stuff like that. It's exciting to me, so I really like it.
Now, you know he's thinking about that for real. One word he just used that chefs use and cooks use, textures of
exactly,
food.
You do as far as your entrepreneurial side to King Sun 820 that you're contributing here?
Basically, what me and my partner bring to the table as far as entrepreneurship with starting your own business, we're involved in a network marketing company. And we think it's a great vehicle to introduce to young men, you know, in a neighborhood, because it's a neighborhood I grew up in, and I didn't have the same opportunities, you know, so I came up, you know, going down the wrong street. So I've been introduced to another way to make things happen versus, you know, you got to play basketball or you got to play football. Most people in the inner city, most of our kids think is only, you only can get out to inner city through entertainment, you know, entertainment and playing basketball. But I believe in something different. I believe if we assist young people with, you know, knowing how to use their mind, the power of the subconscious mind, different things like that, so they can make better decisions. Because what I found for myself, as I learned how to use those things to work with me instead of against me, my life took a different turn.
What's up, everybody? It's your man, Player T. I'm with the lady of the hour right here, Miss Tracy Foster. Now, your husband being the mentor that he is, it's a great thing to want to embrace 8-year-old children and up to 20 and take them under his wing and kind of lead them in the right, but lead them in the right direction, mm-hmm. away from the wrong direction. Okay. Now, to have your help, that's really big. Now, when he set out to do this, what was your thinking on that?
I believe that we need that in the community and someone that has a heart for it. And he does have a heart for it. He thinks about the things that he's gone through from 8 when things that had transpired in his life and that he could be beneficial since God showed a light on it, that he could be beneficial to help children before they become teenagers. You know, once they're teenagers, they're almost set in some of the things that they do. And if you can catch them early, you know, not to discount those that are teenagers, but if you can catch them early and start steering them on the right, you know, on the right path, right. You know, they could help the community also instead of, you know, robbing or selling drugs or whatever. You know, he has a gift for them. He has a heart for them. So I'm to support them, pray for them, pray for the, you know, the kids because they need it.
Now, we all know this is a daunting task, right?
Oh, yeah.
Now, did the light come on in your head that you can actually play a part, even though you're not a male? But did a light come on in your head? And when it did, and knowing it's a daunting task, and you had to accept that responsibility, how has that grown now since you've been at it for a while?
I don't know. I don't know. I'm just, you know, whatever he needs me to do, I'm just here. Right. So, you know, and the kids need to see us being married, right. You know, showing unity and not, you know, I'm not the girlfriend and right. helping him in this and showing how important it is to have a covenant with God. So, you know, what your first ministry is the marriage at home and then it goes outside. So.
How important is it for a male to be in the family and along with the family and bringing the family up in your eyes and in your opinion? How important is it for a male to be in the family and along with the family and bringing the family up in your eyes and in your opinion?
Oh, it's very important. You need two. No matter if the father is not there, the son still has those things that's just like his father, even though he doesn't, you know, he hasn't seen him or whatever. But if the father's there and that could correct some of the things that he did wrong that he see in his child, You know, if he can start, change his life, do something different, then the child will say, okay, my dad used to do the same thing, and he changed. I could change too.
Do you believe a mother should never keep their son or daughter away from the father, no matter what the situation is?
No matter what the situation is, I believe that they yearn for it, for to have their father in their life. And so even if the father is not a good role model, you know, the child can never grow up and say, well, my mother kept me away from you, and it was some things. Even if he's doing some bad things, and hopefully, you know, I mean, something would change, and he'll look at his you know, his child and say, I want to do something better. I want to do something different for him. You know, I made a lot of mistakes. I don't think they should ever keep
them
away.
Most of the time, you have young guys like myself who have come up in houses of dysfunction. And in a house of dysfunction, you're never led by the things of the spirit. You're led by the things of the flesh.
Right.
So your heart content is more geared to what you see. You never even understand that there's a spirit realm. It's beyond the worldly things.
Wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more back to thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There's so much hatred, war, and poverty. Oh, 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 oh.
God, wake up. I like to give honor to the roots, which is Jesus Christ, the soul of God, and my bishop, Shirley McKinney from Christian Fellowship Center, the mentor of my life. She's been a mother to my soul, so I give honor and glory to her. God first.